Hi there, it's Laura from RSVPify. This is a very quick video around recommendations and best practices for setting up your mitzvah registration form. The very first thing to consider is whether you're hosting a simple RSVP or a multi-event RSVP. So take a look at the screen in front of you. A simple RSVP is, can you attend services? Yes, no. Or can you attend the celebration? Yes, no. A multi-event RSVP is a little bit more complicated. You have several different events, maybe throughout the weekend, maybe all on the same day, but you want counts for each individual event. And maybe some events are invite only. So for instance, you have a Friday night dinner that you want to invite out of town guests to. So that would be an invite only secondary event. I'm going to show you what all of this looks like on the registration form. But again, the very first thing to do is think about conceptually, am I having a simple RSVP or a multi-event RSVP? Now, let me take you to the registration form. We can go from there. So right now I'm on the create my event. Right before I can see all the templates, you'll see I chose bar bat mitzvah. I named my event. I put TBD for event location, date and time. But if you have those details, you should include those. And 200 guests. Now I'm going to select a template. Now remember the slide that I showed you about single event versus multi-event. If you pick single event, it'll bring you to a template with just really one question and maybe a few follow-up questions, but one really yes-no question. If you click multi-event, it'll bring you to a little bit more of a complicated template. I'm going to select that right now. Sometimes it's easiest to start with the most complicated cases. So as it's creating my event, note that I'll be prompted to update my website, update my form, add an invite list, add security. We're not going to talk about most of this right now. We're just going to talk about, your registration form. So I'm going to head to my left navigation panel. The form builder is the same thing as the registration form. I'm going to click it. The very first thing you're going to note is this very vague first question. Will you help us celebrate? This is what we call the primary block. It is critical in a multi-event that you start with something very vague. What happens, it's very tempting, but what happens if you put something like services here is that if someone responds can't make it, the rest of the registration form is not going to be accurate. Because really, just because they can't attend services doesn't mean they can't attend the party, right? Or any of your other events that you plan to host that weekend. So your first question should be very vague. Will you help us celebrate? Yes, no. And don't worry, folks will be able to respond for more than one. That's what this counter is for. I'll show you what this looks like in just a moment. Then notice our secondary events. These are the things that are our actual events, the things that we want actual counts for the weekend. So we have services here, a party here. You could add brunch. You could add dinner. You could add whatever you'd like. And these are set up as secondary events. And that's because I might have invite only, I might have a few follow-up questions. But if you really just have a simple yes, no, for example, for services, it doesn't matter to you what the count is, you could do something like add a custom question. And I'm gonna add it for now just to show you the registration experience. I'm gonna do select one, move myself over here. Services. Add a yes, add a no. And for the sake of demonstrating this, I'm gonna ask this to attend to once per group. Again, because I don't really, the count for services is not important to me. So I'm gonna ask this once per group if they're attending the primary event. Again, the primary event is a dummy event here. It is a will you help us celebrate? And I'm gonna ask it to everybody, but I could offer to ask if they're tagged with a certain audience. I'm going to show you what this form looks like now. So click into it. I'm going to reply, move myself back over here. I'm going to reply for a family of three. It's asking once per group. My family is going to make services. But if you wanted to ask it in a different way, you wanted to ask individual counts, I'm going to attend services, my partner's not, maybe, and my child is not. It gives you a little bit of option there. Party, attending, attending, attending. And it takes me to the rest of the form. So again, it's very critical for that first block to be very generic, so you'll be able to navigate through the rest of the form.